allowing me to record your testimony. I have been using this machine to keep track of my journey, for my dear sister's own sense of safety when I am unable to assure her of my own. There has been little else to assure her of. The snow and the ice. Myself on this ship, trapped. I am shocked by your continued survival, sir.
You have provided me with an opportunity to continue.
The ice takes what it can, it appears, sir, as nature is wont.
And yet, you are travelling to the North Pole.
A worthy errand, sir, of adventure, of knowledge.
Knowledge?
To find more, sir, to know more, to become master of my own self.
To prove that you are master of yourself, yes?
To see what could be done in the face of the unchangeable. What else is on this earth to seek out?
You are not alone on this ship.
A necessary crew, sir, but all sailors and working men. I embark on this endeavour alone.
Alone?
Sir, I must ask why you were so far upon the ice. We were beyond surprised to see you, sir, you understand?
To seek one who fled from me.
But the ice?
Do you believe that the breaking up of the ice has made pursuit impossible?
It took us days of our own, sir, to push through, and now we are trapped! Surely one man cannot head out on the ice alone, let alone to find another.
Ah, but you are out on the ice too, are you not?
Stuck, sir, yes. I have made sure my eventual success is all but guaranteed. I have a ship ready for the winter. You have a sled. Had a sled. Lost to the ice.
But you believe still. Despite your predicament, you can succeed.
I do. I know. I believe knowledge above all else is imperative. Gives man the ability to command as he please. It is,
I believe.
How gladly I would sacrifice my fortune, my existence, my every hope for my quest. One man's life or death be but a small price to pay.
For success.
For knowledge. For ultimate understanding. To master all.
Oh, unhappy stranger.
Sir?
You too.
I too.
I cannot. I must not allow you.
But you have the same dreams as I. I have never met another who shares my ambition, sir. I have longed for a fellow mind.
We are unfashioned creatures, half made up. Once I shared your dreams, but I have lost everything. I cannot begin life anew.
Surely it is not too late, sir.
For me it is. But for you...
Sir, what are you... Let me help you, sir.
These tapes I made during the most pivotal moments of my life.
I cannot take them.
You must. I have no use for them now, but you... Let me share my life to you, my disasters. If you are pursuing the same dangers, then you must be prepared. You must steady your disbelief and listen for your own good.
Sir, please rest.
Then rest I shall, but you must listen to these, my tapes, my notes of my life, and dwell upon my decisions to reflect upon yours.
This is unnecessary.
I am out on the ice. Close to death, pursuing a dangerous mistake I created, destruction and disaster, my destiny. Do not do the same.
I am not you, sir.
I must compel you for your own good.
I am not on a course towards disaster.
Nothing can alter my destiny. allow me to assist yours.
To humour the sick, dear sister. The tapes of Victor Frankenstein.
Frankenstein by Mary Shelley. Adapted by Sophie Wright. Brought to you by Castle Theatre Company and Green Door Theatre Company.
July 1723, the first day of these records of my personal explorations into natural philosophy and chemistry. 2 years since I've started study at Ingolstadt, and at last there has been an occurrence within my study, a question that has enraptured me. Where does the principle of life spring forth from?
You cannot. Surely, Victor, this is a madness.
If you cannot contain your outbursts and...
Life! This is impossible to determine.
Master Waldman believes it is possible.
Waldman humours your fancies. Kremp, on the other hand.
Kremp humours me. Waldman encourages my interests. My searches for truth. I am continuing with these notes, Clerval. If you would remove yourself... Then...
I am leaving, Victor. Do not worry. You must inform me of your progress, however little I can contribute.
This I must do alone. I must interrogate death to find life. It is considered a mystery, and yet I believe that the proper place to start...
Exponent 1. Observation of natural decay and corruption of the human body. One form of a man, now corpse. There. Death has now corrupted life. The worm inherits the wonders of the eye and the brain. The limbs are stiff, the skin is pale and marble-like, the hands mimic the bone underneath. Life to death, and death to life. I have breath, and he does not. My heart beats, and his does not. There. I detect a note. Moment 3. Observation of decay on a partial corpse. I will now be subjecting the corpse to... Experiment 13. The difference was marginal when the salve was applied, yet the twitching...
Your shoes covered in mud.
You have letters.
From Elizabeth, Victor. They are most... kind. Gentle, perhaps. Are you and she...
I will reply shortly, you can assure... Tonight, experiment 27 will involve the application of a different sort of electricity, resulting in the blood flowing a little slower than healthy pulse rate, but it is close.
You should eat, Victor. Something if not this.
I need to complete this.
Please.
Closer
to discovering the secrets of the heart, the manner in which it pulsates in the chest.
Tools, the fluids, the midnight travels.
Henry!
I have seen your light on in the early hours, night after night.
I told you, my work...
If this is in any way related to the passing of your mother, I... Victor. Dinner.
Tomorrow.
No!
Replicating the lung movement will be difficult, but I believe that the work that lies in the papers...
This discovery is so great. All the steps that have led to this moment have been obliterated, and I now only have the result. I have the secret to creating life. I have discovered to prepare a frame, though, to create the intricacies of fibers, muscles, veins. This I have yet to disentangle. Should it be a creation like I, or one of simpler organization? The materials at present within my command hardly appear adequate to so arduous an undertaking as a man, but yet I cannot doubt. I will ultimately succeed. I must prepare. S2 again was imperfect within the mechanics and the minute bones of the feet. To make a being of gigantic stature. He shall be 8 feet in height and proportionally large.
Your face is so pale. I cannot help but feel concerned.
I simply failed again to say bird. It is within my reach, Henry. I'm close.
If you just tell
no.
me...
No! I'm close, that is all.
As you were yesterday and the day before. Victor.
Henry.
Just come for a walk. The summer has proved to be the most charming yet.
I just...
The local charnel house has yet again proved promising.
My father has called me home. No academia will ever do me good, you see, if I cannot become employed.
Gone? For how long?
For several months, but I shall return for the next academic term.
I'll remain here for...
For your experiments, for science, for knowledge, yes. Fear not, dear Victor. I will send letters of how lovely Elizabeth looks.
Wet. Pulsing, but not useful. Not without... The hand must be bigger. The arm must be stronger. I can. I must. There is life.
My professors have discovered me. My interest in less modern approaches to natural sciences, academics and thinkers that are not of our time. Master Kremp, Master Waldman, perhaps believes in the value of the works I'm reading, but Kremp does not. Ridicules me, openly mocks me in class, but I am not here for thoughts of our time. If men of this age have failed to take us forward, then no progress shall be made, and we shall stay beholden to the limitations placed upon us by the cycles of life and death. Death is merely a condition of nature, and man can master nature. How could I not be inspired by the work of Cornelius Agrippa, Paracelsus, Albertus, Magnus, men who have penetrated deeper into the elements and the natural world? Master Kremp is a squat little man with a gruff voice and a repulsive countenance. He presumes that the modern philosophers understand more about the universe than the geniuses that preceded them. Well, I am not content with the results promised by these contemporaries. These modern masters promise very little, but my philosophers, they penetrate into the recesses of nature and show how she works in her hiding places.
They ascend into the heavens. They have discovered how the blood circulates and the nature of the air we breathe. They have acquired new and almost unlimited powers. There is more. The labors of men of genius, however erroneously directed, eventually succeed. I will improve our condition. I will show them. I can do it. It has come. At last. Test 563. My first attempt at full resurrection. I have all tools accounted for. The building is empty. The sample has been prepared. It is time. Time to infuse the spark of life.
Victor, are you in?
Victor!
Henry.
Look! I was allowed to return early. You may easily believe how difficult it was to persuade my father, but behold, he has permitted me to return to this, the land of knowledge.
How did you leave my father? Dear William, how's Elizabeth?
Oh, very well, very happy. A little uneasy that they seldom hear from you. I will lecture you on their behalf, but... are you all right?
Henry.
You are so thin, so pale. You look as if you have not slept for several nights.
You... Yes. I have been so deeply engaged in one occupation, but I hope... I sincerely hope that it is now at an end, and I am at last
Victor,
free.
Let me see your laboratory. No, I want to understand, dear Frankenstein. Let me see what you've been up to.
Henry,
let me...
Don't, get away! No!
Christ alive! Victor, what happened?
Empty.
What? Are you well?
The room, it's empty.
Should it not be?
Gone. My notes, my recording device, they have been taken.
A thief? Victor, what?
Oh, thank God! Oh, thank God!
What on earth has happened to you, Victor? What for God's sake is the matter? How ill are you? What is the cause of all this?
Save me.
Victor! Victor! Stay here until you are well again.
He calls me. He sees me.
Until you have stopped talking nonsense, at the very least, you are to stay.
He's there!
Victor, don't touch that. Stop! Cannot, Victor. Please.
You must. For me.
They do not know. Your father, Elizabeth, your family, none of them have a clue to your condition.
They cannot know. My father must not travel. My family are torn by my mother's... Her death primed them for disaster. They would be distraught, unable to help.
You are not so ill that you will not survive.
And he might know. He might find out that I am weak. Henry,
stop this nonsense.
It's out there, out there. Somewhere.
All right, enough.
Leaves. Are the trees returning?
Yes, they are. It will be an uncommonly beautiful spring, I should say.
Oh, dearest Clerval, how kind, how very good you are to me. This whole winter you confined yourself to my sick room. How shall I ever repay you?
You shall, if you get well as fast as you can. And as you appear to be in such good spirits...
Anything for my nursemaid.
Your father and cousin would be happy if they received a letter from you, in your own handwriting. They hardly know how ill you've been.
They know I have been ill.
Not of its seriousness, Victor, I did promise.
Is that all?
They are uneasy at your long silence.
Without delay.
You will be glad, then, to see a letter has been lying here for you. From your cousin.
Elizabeth, what does she say?
That she prevented your father from travel to you due to your illness, that she is relieved to hear of your recovery, that your brother Ernst has grown, that your youngest brother William is a delight and a little mischievous, that Justine has returned. Who is Justine?
A soft girl who has lived a life of grief and who had previously lived in our house for some time. She left to be with her aunt. He must have passed if Justine had returned to live with us.
Again, William, he appears to be in trouble.
But he is well.
Thriving, it appears.
Oh, Elizabeth. I will write instantly and relieve them from their anxiety. And Henry, I must introduce you to your new professors. You must meet them now you and I are in the same cohort.
You must be well if you are once again thinking of classes.
We could go to the library today. I could show you where the papers are held.
Oh, let us enjoy the sun today, dear Victor.
Please, Henry, compose yourself.
I shall not, Victor. I shall remain entirely as jolly as I am. Oh...
Oh, you shall regret this in the morning. You shall regret this. My head shall regret this.
Oh, I don't believe neither my head nor myself shall regret any moment of this glorious night, dear Victor. And neither shall yours.
I do not believe... Believe that...
Not for a second.
No.
Your tape recorder has its little light on.
Oh, I get into the habit of recording my notes.
We should leave something worthy of recording, Victor.
Oh, please don't.
A song!
I shan't.
Can you not sing with me?
I do! I did before, just then. You heard.
Sing with me! I shall make a new song.
I will not know the words if you're creating them from nothing.
That should not stop the smartest man in all of Ingolstadt! The most scientific of minds. The most brilliant of brains. To hell with Krempt!
Master Krempt cannot hear your calls from here.
From your secret laboratory?
Not in my palace of science. My domain.
Oh, don't read that letter now, Victor. Leave it. Save it for tomorrow.
Dearest Clavel, it is from my father. It'll only take a moment. Oh. Oh, God.
Huh? Victor? Victor, are you quite all right? Hey, Victor, come on. What is it?
William. It's... William. He's been murdered.
Ernst came, and we inquired if he had seen his brother, and he said he had been playing with him and that William had run away to hide. And continued to search until night fell. About 5 in the morning, I discovered my lovely boy, whom the night before I had seen blooming in health, stretched on the grass, livid and motionless, the print of the murderer's fingers on his neck. The print. William, dear angel, with our mother now, this is thy funeral.
Oh, dear God! What'd you do there, you monster! Filthy, 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 you murderer!
Victor, is everything all right?
Father!
Victor, are you well? You said you would be resting.
I cannot. I saw... Father William's murder.
I know, dear boy, I know. Oh. William. Our darling. Our pride.
September 1727. As I am unable to share my thoughts on William's murderer with my family, I must keep record of them somehow. Somehow. In the hope that I can avoid such tragedy again. I know who has taken sweet William, destroyed our family. That wretch, that filthy demon, he is the murderer. Nothing of human shape could have destroyed my fair brother. I have cast this being amongst mankind, my own spirit, let loose from the grave, delighting in carnage and misery, forced to destroy all that is dear to me. I do not know what I shall do. I cannot convey these thoughts to my family. I'll be looked upon as mad. No. Who could possibly arrest a creature capable? Who could possibly pretend to have taken William instead? What? What is it? Ernst.
Father told me you were home.
I am, yes.
Who are you talking to?
I'm making audio. It is nothing.
Have you seen Elizabeth yet?
No.
She, most of all, requires consolation. She accuses herself of having caused William's death. But since the murderer has been discovered...
Discovered?
Good God, how could that be? I arrived only yesterday.
It was done in the early hours, brother. We thought it best you rest.
But it is impossible. I saw him just last night.
Who?
The murderer has been apprehended.
Yes.
How? How possibly?
What do you mean?
But if he is caught, surely...
Victor,
but...
it is worse than you could imagine.
You must believe me when I
Who
say...
Who could have possibly foreseen that Justine Moritz could be capable of so appalling a crime?
Justine? Accused?
Alas, it is true.
But wrongfully, surely... Everyone knows that she is kind and gentle. No one believes it, surely.
Not at first. But she had been taken ill, in bed for several days. She was found with a picture of Mother.
Mother?
A collection of facts that have forced conviction upon us. And her behaviour has been so... so confused. Victor, it leaves no hope for doubt. She has been convicted.
Justine. No, Ernst. She is innocent.
What?
You must believe me. Justine is no murderer.
How? You arrived last night, Victor. How do you know?
Trust me, I know. Father! Father, I know the murderer.
We do also, Victor. I have been ignorant that I did not see so much depravity in what I valued so highly.
But, Father, you are mistaken!
If we are, then she can be acquitted. Justice, Victor. Justice triumphs in the end.
So how does it... Oh!
See the lights.
What does that mean?
That it is recording properly.
Oh, how marvellous, Victor. Your arrival, dear cousin, fills me with hope.
I should have been here sooner, Elizabeth.
No, you could not have. How could you have known that she... that William...
It'll be all right.
I am unable to fully convince myself of the truth. That Justine, someone I knew and dearly doted upon, whom I trusted completely, that she was capable of such monstrosity. But your father is convinced, Ernst too. And I am alone in thinking she is entirely innocent. You, perhaps, could find some means to free her. You are, after all, the smartest man I have ever met.
Science, perhaps, but law? Morals?
Who is safe if she is convicted of crime?
Breathe, Elizabeth. She is innocent.
I sincerely hope so. I love her. If she is condemned, I shall never know joy again. And even more so, without William, my dearest, sweet boy.
Oh, trust me, my dear. There is nothing to fear. She is innocent, I know it.
I hope so.
Let your spirits be cheered by the assurance of her acquittal. I may be a man of science, but believe me when I say that I am entirely convinced by her freedom.
Everyone else believes in her guilt. Makes me feel wretched.
She will be freed. My father will ensure it.
Cannot be serious. She is innocent.
Elizabeth, there is nothing left to be done.
You cannot believe that Justine murdered William. You cannot possibly believe. If you truly had the power to stop them...
If she was innocent, truly, then she would not have been found guilty. Elizabeth, please, control yourself.
She has already confessed her guilt. More evidence was hardly required in so obvious a case. A decisive condemnation.
You were decided against her.
I beg your pardon.
My cousin...
How shall I ever believe in human goodness again? Justine, whom I loved as a sister, how could she put on that innocence?
Please. Please.
Justine, why did you rob me of my last consolation? I believed in you.
Do you join in my enemies to crush me? To condemn me as a murderer?
Move along.
Why do you believe I'm so wicked?
You confessed! You confessed to my...
I confessed to a lie!
Move along!
What? Justine, why did you... You should not die! Stop! Stop!
It is okay. I do not fear death. That pang is past. Just say you believe in me. My innocence. That you love me. Still?
Yes. Yes, yes. You say you're being hung on a lie. What would you...
Then I am content.
Justine! Justine!
It is done.
No, please!
This murderer shall be hanged here for the murder of William Frankenstein.
I shall not look away. She deserves that.
Condemned by the jury for her crimes.
There was nothing that could be done. Justine has taken the punishment for my crimes. I could have proclaimed the truth, but be cast as a madman, and she still would have taken the sentence. She perished the murderer. This was my doing. Her death. William's death. Elizabeth's grief, my father's woe. All the work of my thrice cursed hands. My work, my destiny, my fate to bring life into the world was to sow destruction and misery. Again, my loves, you shall raise the funeral wail, and the sound of your lamentation shall again and again be heard by the harbinger of shadows. I cannot. I must not again. I beheld the graves of my William and Justine, victims. Not again. Never again. I am alive and I must use it for good.
Record this so you will later understand how intelligent I can be.
You know I regard you as bright, Elizabeth.
Good. Then agree with me. You need fresh air, dear Victor, to get out of this house of mourning.
You too are grieving.
We all are. Misery has come home and men appear to be as monsters thirsting for each other's blood. But I know she was innocent, and I am assured of that belief that while she is not with us, I can content myself with a little sadness that she is with God now. Victor, Victor, calm. It is okay. These events have affected me, but I am not so wretched as you are.
She was guiltless and she died for it.
And she felt content to do so.
Oh.
Despair not so deeply. This is why a day trip will do you some good. Alone. In the mountains, taking it all in.
I must rest.
You need a change of scenery.
Thank you. dare not the fierce vengeance of my arm wreaked upon your miserable head. Begone! Restore those victims who you have so viciously murdered!
I expected this reception.
You speak.
All men hate the wretched. How then must I be hated? Miserable beyond all living things.
God.
Yet you, my creator, you detest and spurn me, thy own creation. You decide to kill me. How dare you play with life and death?
Come no closer.
Do your duty towards me, and I will do mine towards you and the rest of mankind.
My duty?
I am your duty.
Heresy!
Comply, and I will leave you and them in peace.
What if I don't?
If you refuse, I will glut the maw of death until it is satisfied with the blood of your remaining friends.
Abhorrent monster! The tortures of hell are too milk of vengeance for your crimes! You wretched devil!
Be calm! Listen to me before you vent your hatred. Have I not suffered enough that you seek to increase my misery?
I gave you life!
Yes, you did. I'm your creature. I'll even be milked and docile to my natural king.
You speak lies. You killed my brother. You sentenced Justine to death.
You sentenced her. You chose not to reveal your truth and let her die.
Beast!
You abandoned me. You chose to leave me. I am your creature, Frankenstein. I ought to be your Adam, but you have cast me from the Garden of Eden. I am the fallen angel. Everywhere I see bliss, I am irreversibly excluded. I was good, and misery has made me a fiend. And you have the power to make me happy and virtuous again.
I will not hear you. There is nothing I can do for you, monster!
You abhor me, creator. What hope then can I gather from your fellow creatures, who will owe me nothing? If all mankind knew of my existence, they would do as you've done and arm themselves for my destruction. Should I not hate those who hate me?
You killed!
Yes. But you would kill me. You would destroy your own creature. They would all murder me, and so what must I do? Let your compassion be moved. Do not disdain me. Behold.
My notes. My recording device. You stole!
I had nothing but this. My true birthright. I listened to you on the night of my birth. Onwards, and I made my own notes.
Your own notes.
Listen to my tale, then leave or comfort me. Judge what I deserve, but hear me first. And then, if you wish, destroy your own handiwork.
I shudder to reflect. Cursed be the day that you first drew breath. Begone, relieve me.
I will go, creator, but first...
Don't touch me!
Hear me! Hear my tale. The sun is yet high in the heavens. Before it descends, you will have heard my story and can decide. Here. Come. Listen. Follow me across the ice.
God forgive me.
Oh my God, what is that?
Get away!
Help!
Go,
run!
Go!
He shall be 8 feet in height and proportionally large. He shall be 8 feet in height and... He shall be eight...
Shall be.
Oh my God. What is that?
Oi!
Get out! You're not welcome here! Leave!
Get out!
Don't come any closer!
Get out!
No!
Go on, leave!
This I have yet to disentangle. Should it be a creation like I, or one of simpler organization? The materials at present within my command hardly appear adequate to so arduous an undertaking as a man, but yet...
Hello? Who goes there? Hello?
Hello? Hello?
Who is that? I am blind. Please, come closer.
Hello? Who?
I have nothing to take but food. Please, take the bread. Spare us the rest. We have very little. Are you okay?
Hello?
Are you hungry? We have more.
Hungry?
Yes, hungry. Here. So, when I speak into here, you'll be able to listen to it. I want you to practice saying it back. Okay, first, hello.
Hello.
Yes, good. You say that when people are approaching, or you wish to make a friend.
Friend?
Friend is someone who we care for, someone who we love.
Friend.
Yes, good. This is farm.
Farm.
Good. My daughter and her husband, they tend to the farm. They look after it, make sure we have food. The ground is growing. Nothing dies without reason.
Dies?
We all die. Even the ground of this farm will die eventually. It's a lot of work to stay alive, as I'm sure you very well know. You have to eat and drink, breathe, stay warm, find shelter, sleep. It is harder to look after others.
Hard.
Yes, very good. The origin of the word harder. My daughter. Well, I wasn't always blind, but now there is a lot of work to do.
Harder.
Yes, more difficult than before.
You girls, I'm sorry, I didn't think my arse is big enough to trouble you so.
You are plowing the field and I'm...
Oh, you're you are not sowing the seeds now, then.
I'm trying to. Dearest love of mine, would you
dear
stop?
Love.
Stop.
Dear love. Dear love of mine.
Paradise lost.
Paradise lost.
Good. It is a tale of the fallen angel, Lucifer, and how he became Satan. It is a battle between angels and demons, but mostly about love and power, and who has created us.
Love and power.
Take this. I know we are not yet complete with your alphabet, but as your knowledge expands, this will be instrumental in allowing your confidence to bloom.
What is created?
Oh, well, we living creatures, one and all, must come from somewhere, yes? Someone or something has given us life.
Given us life? We have not got it.
We do not create it ourselves, no. It must be provided to us. Our God gave us life, and he expects us to live with love and piousness in return. But we can talk about.
Yes! Yes! Life!
Creator, God, did you give me a life? Why? Why did you leave?
Look there.
Incredible.
All of it.
My God.
Done. All we do now is sow the seeds.
Someone out there, looking after us.
Sheer kindness.
I can be kind. I can be loving. I can have friends.
Again, look, the water has been refilled.
Every single bucket.
So farewell, hope, and with hope, farewell, fear. Farewell, remorse. All good to me is lost.
Excellent, excellent. You've come along so far.
But who could be looking out for us, though?
Does it matter if we know?
Well, I suppose not.
Then enjoy it, my love. Enjoy what's been given.
I am not the creature you ran from, Creator Victor. I am more. I have been good. I have done a kindness. I am more than you thought.
Who is there? Friend?
Pardon this intrusion. I am a traveler in want of a little rest.
Oh,
sir.
Enter, please, and I will try in what manner I can to relieve your wants. I'm afraid I am blind, and so will find it difficult to procure specific things for you.
Do not trouble yourself, sir. It is just warmth and rest I need.
Oh, you sound familiar. Are you from...
I am not local, sir. No, I was unwanted and deserted by family.
I have no friends upon this earth.
Oh, do not despair. To be friendless is unfortunate. But the hearts of men are full and giving.
Perhaps, but they are prejudiced against me. I appear... men look upon me and see only a heartless monster.
If you are blameless, can you change their minds?
I am about to undertake that task. I have friends whom I dearly love, but whom I have never met. I have been giving them help from afar, daily kindnesses to soothe their lives, but they do not know it has been me.
Where do these friends reside? Perhaps I know of them.
Near this spot.
Oh, tell me who.
I trust your kindness.
Tell me their names.
Please do not desert me.
Who?
You and your family. Please, you said...
Great God! Is that...
Great God! Oh God! Get out! Get out, monster! Demon!
Creator, why have you cursed me? Why is it that humanity looks upon my face and deems it terrifying? Why? Oh, please, miss!
Get out of here!
No!
Demon! Thief!
Out of thy head I spring. Amazement seized all the host of heaven. Back they recoiled, afraid at first, and called me sin. Called me sin, Creator, do you hear? I am like Satan. I am the devil. You did not make me another, Creator. I am one, the only, alone, all alone. I have tried to live and to survive, but to survive is not enough. I'm friendless and alone. And you, Creator, Victor, you've made it impossible for me to be happy. I'm ugly. I am a monster. I am a demon sent straight from hell. Is that not what humanity sees in me? Is that not all I can be to them? Then why? Why should I be good? Why should I try when I have no one and no one cares for me? I swear to you, Creator. I swear on the bones you stole from me. I will have my revenge.
Let me go! Let me go! Papa! Papa!
Calm. Calm. You must calm.
I shall not.
Please, it is just... I am a friend.
No, you are not.
I am. I promise. I am lonely. We will be friends.
My papa is Monsieur Frankenstein, and he will punish you. Papa!
Frankenstein.
I'm his son.
Victor, my creator.
Let me go. Help, please.
I'm sorry, child. But I made a promise. Can create desolation. I too. He is not invulnerable. I am powerful. I am powerful. Behold, Victor. Look what you have made me do. You understand now?
What do you want of me?
I am alone. You created one of me.
You wish. You want me to.
You must create me a companion.
A female?
Yes.
Dear God, you're serious.
Oh, you cannot refuse.
I can.
Your duty to me.
You may render me the most miserable of men, but you shall never make me base in my own eyes. Another of you, so what? You can wreak havoc together?
Creator!
No! I cannot, no. Be gone!
You are in the wrong, listen. I am malicious because I am miserable. You, my creator, would tear me to pieces and triumph and tell me why I should pity man more than he pities me. You would not call it murder if you could throw me into the ice and destroy me. See? This passion? You don't think you're the cause of its success? What I ask of you is reasonable.
Reasonable?
Reasonable and moderate. I demand a creature of another sex, yes, but as hideous as myself. We shall be monsters, but together, cut off from the world. It will not be a wonderful life, but we will be harmless, free from the misery I presently feel. Creator, Victor, lend me some sympathy. Make me happy. Please. If you agree, you will never see us again. We shall take ourselves away and know peace. I see compassion in you.
You propose to exile yourselves. How can you, when you long for the love of mankind? You will attempt to join society again, see their hatred again. Your evil will be...
No, I swear to you. By the creator that made me, that with a companion, I will never approach a man again. How could I betray your sympathy?
You swear to be harmless.
Yes.
No more violence.
None.
I consent. But you must uphold your end of the deal.
Oh, I swear to you, if you grant my prayer, you will never see me again. Oh, Victor, thank you. Thank you. Depart home. Go. Go. I will be watching your progress.
It promises. It swears. No more violence. No more death. I can do this. I can do this. After this, no more. Just this. Once more. One more try. One more try.
Gone? For how long?
4 months at most. Just Elizabeth.
You have been gone to Ingolstadt for years, and now you have returned, and we have been able to. Victor, tell me if I am assuming.
No, Elizabeth, I swear we shall be married.
I thought so too, and yet off you go.
Another day has passed since you encouraged me to rest, to get away.
For a walk, not to France, to England, to Scotland.
Well, Henry will be going with me.
Henry hasn't lost a friend and a brother in a week. I am just trying to understand. It has been a harrowing week, dear Victor, and I am much better for it with you by my side.
As I you. But...
There is always something.
It is for my work, my passion. And to find a sense of peace.
One you cannot find here.
Yes.
(sighs) I have learned long ago that I shall never comprehend the bond between you and your natural sciences, your alchemists and your books, and I do love you, Victor. But if we are to be husband and wife, as we both want, then shall I be second to your work?
Elizabeth.
It is true.
You are what comes after.
Second, then.
No. The destination.
It's commenced once Henry and I have started to travel. I've collected my notes from my previous work and packed and... Once we reach England, I have plans to journey north to...
Your departure is prepared. When will Clerval be arriving?
Presently. Henry is bringing his luggage here.
Ah. I know we have already discussed your journey, but...
Father, please...
William is gone. Justine is hanged. Must you leave so soon?
There is a location in Scotland of... great importance to my...
Yes, your project, science and knowledge and saving mankind. Oh, poor Clerval. I do hope you will not subject him to too much academia.
Yes, Father.
Have you seen Elizabeth today?
I... We talked yesterday. I said my farewells.
Victor, hardly the proper manner in which to treat your future spouse... Ensure you write to us more frequently this time.
Yes, Father.
You cannot leave your fiancée so coldly as you did.
No, Father. My future hopes and prospects are entirely bound in the expectation of our union.
Good. Good. I do hope this cheers you, my son. You have been more miserable than I have seen you ever before. Not since...
The father. Ah. I must be getting on.
Of course. Your mother would be proud of you.
Okay. Should start this tape again. I'm using them to track my plans.
Plans?
Work. When I reach Scotland.
Work? Victor! Look! There is a charm in these banks. Of this divine river that I never saw before. I have seen the mountains and lakes of Switzerland, and they are majestic and strange, but behold! The Rhine!
I do see.
Surely the spirit that inhabits this place has a soul more in harmony with man than those who retire to the inaccessible peaks of the Alps.
You are but a poet.
How could you not?
It is a river, Henry. It is beautiful, but...
Do you not love a woman because she is beautiful? Why then should I not love this river? This river... Victor, look at her, this river! Oh,
get your hands away!
Finish your fish.
I cannot, I'm full.
We were told about the deliciousness of the fish from the English south coast, but it has truly exceeded my expectations.
You have a pretty word to say about everything.
We do not have to go to Scotland.
You stay then. I cannot stay in Cambridge for my work.
Why not? The brightest minds, the oldest institutions?
The dustiest books. Their laboratory isn't a lot to my standards, Henry. You simply wish to stay to chase that poor woman around.
Not the woman, Victor. The river! Oh, the river.
I truly do not mind, Henry.
Only my father's friends have sons here, and I must pay them visits.
I do not mind at all. I will come and meet you back in Glasgow. You'll be here for a month.
A month? Yes, but Victor, what could possibly take you a month?
I shall see you then.
So mysterious. Do look after yourself.
Don't forget to send Elizabeth letters.
She's not my betrothed.
Say you will.
Victor.
Travelled over 25 miles today, and tomorrow we shall reach Aberdeen at last. The Orkneys are rumoured to be remote and sparsely populated. I believe this is where my work shall be.
There will be no other disturbances in this hut.
This landscape reminds me of home, somehow. This shall do.
If you're sure.
I will need certain supplies.
Well, food is available from the village.
I mean supplies for my work.
Like what?
They are not for the faint-hearted. There is not much work in the way of rediscovering life. The aim here is to mimic the human flesh of a woman, to ensure life will be kept within the body in the most realistic manner possible. I must not stray from the task at hand. The shadows that stalk me must not be allowed to interfere in my progress. There are stakes now, ones that were not present before. This time, I must get it right. Okay. Day one. Day 35. Through my previous research, I have determined that the specimen will be unable to reproduce.
A body left in the church from Tuesday, I believe.
Good, good. You will be compensated.
Just don't get caught. I don't want to be implicated. You understand?
Similarly to the previous experiment, the feet of the specimen are... Focus. The feet. The feet of the specimen are not responding as I expected. I do not believe that the pulse of a woman is very different to that of a man, so the heart is responding strongly.
You have post, sir.
Leave it there.
It appears urgent, or... What's that smell? Do you need your food thrown away?
I said leave it! Lungs, liver, kidney, lungs, liver, kidney, do I need spares? Awoken in the middle of the night. I swore I heard. Oh, God. The work. It is progressing. Please. I cannot sleep. I cannot rest. When I close my eyes, Henry and Elizabeth. If I'm awake, I should work. Next Monday, the specimen shall be tested. Must add in the sums. Two more days.
Burn your feet.
Must test the joints once more. One more time. It has occurred to me that I have been here before. I have been engaged in the same manner of work as I was 3 years ago. I am forming another being whose dispositions I am equally ignorant of as I was of the first. She might be 10,000 times more evil than her mate. She might want to murder. He has sworn to exile themselves, but what of her? She hasn't agreed to anything. What if she despises humanity? What if she despises him? What if they want children?
There is nothing more important than the pursuit of knowledge, but this is a pursuit of destruction. I must protect the ones I have left. Oh, God! Oh, God, what have I done? No! No! Christ! God! No! Damn you! Damn you! No! You have destroyed the work which you began. You dare break your promise. I have endured toil and misery. I left Switzerland with you. I crept along the shores of the Rhine, the coast of England, the barren lands of Scotland. While you enjoyed your trip with your friends, I've endured fatigue, cold, hunger, sustained only by the hope you gave me with your promise. And now you dare destroy my only lifeline.
Because
you have made a mistake. I have power. You hiding in a cupboard from me. You believe yourself miserable now. I will make you so wretched the very light of day will be hateful to you.
I will not. I will not. I will not set loose another demon whose only delight is death.
Shall each man find a wife and each beast have his mate and I be alone? By your design! Man, you may hate, but beware, you will pass in dread and misery. You can blast my hopes and dreams, but revenge remains to me. I may die, but first you, my tyrant and tormentor, shall curse the sun that gazes on your misery.
Leave me. I am resolute. You cannot bend me.
It is so.
Leave!
Remember, I shall be with you on your wedding night.
Monster! Demon!
Sir? Who is it you wish to see?
I have been informed that Henry Clerval has been residing here.
He is, sir. Can I ask who's inquiring?
My name is Victor Frankenstein. He should be expecting me.
Yes, sir. Head right on in.
Henry. Henry, are you here? Henry, I have returned. Henry, I will enter, and if you are not properly clothed... Henry.
Oh! Oh! God! Oh, my dearest Henry! Deprived of life, it got here first! Oh, God! Oh, God! Help! Help! Someone! Oh, two I have already destroyed but you! Henry, my friend, my friend!
Oh, God! I am summoning the police, sir, please!
It is my fault, it is my doing. He took him, he took him!
Sir, please, step away from the body!
Henry, no, Henry!
Sir, step away!
You don't understand? I did not murder my friend.
You were found with the body, sir, saying it is my doing.
No, no, there has been some sort of misunderstanding. No! Please, the murderer is out there. No!
This is not his first instance of raving and fever.
He was found committing to the crime, Mr. Frankenstein. We were not left with a great deal of choice.
No, I understand. But the marks on Clerval's neck do not match my son's hands. He has a history of unsettling but false remarks, particularly when he is ill, as I have been told he is currently. You surely should be able to release
him. Yes, sir. But we will have to keep him longer to make sure. Complete paperwork, you understand?
This is unnecessary.
Sir, I will have to ask you to return tomorrow.
Can I not visit him?
Sir, we cannot allow...
He is my son. First William, then Justine, then Henry. Victor, my son, please. Do not succumb to whatever demons are chasing you. You are needed here. You'll be happier to see the father who has ensured your freedom.
Father? You're here?
Yes. Glasgow is where you were trapped, so Glasgow is where I came.
I am to be let go.
Circumstances. There was little evidence to prove your guilt, despite your feverish confessions. I had to prove that you had a history of illness.
You're safe. Elizabeth, Ernst.
Yes, yes, but... Oh, poor Clerval.
Yes. Yes. Some destiny of the most horrible sort hangs over me. I must live to fulfill it, or else I would have joined Henry.
Victor, please calm yourself.
I am the cause. I murdered him. William, Justine, Henry, they all die by my hands.
There is nothing to be done. You should not have departed while you were still skin and bone.
While the law remained partially convinced of my guilt. No. There was nothing more that could be done for me in Glasgow, Father. We must return. Elizabeth waits for us.
Your fever?
The visions have passed.
You shout in your sleep.
I still insist.
We return home, yes. Yes, I know.
Victor, you've returned. Oh.
You are well. Everyone here is well.
Better for seeing you, darling. How are you faring?
Better. Better, I swear. Oh, Elizabeth.
Your letters were concerning.
I have something to share. Wait. You are thinner too.
It has been difficult for me. Dear Henry was a friend too. And after the time we have had... I am well, dear Victor. Do not trouble yourself, Mr. Frankenstein.
Good to see you once more, Elizabeth. Have you told him yet?
Told me what?
The wedding. Our wedding.
It was decided before my departure to Glasgow that your wedding shall be held 1 week after my return, provided that you were well enough.
We wanted to bring some joy back into the house.
A week?
Is that satisfactory?
I was hoping... We could spend some time together before the wedding, maybe travel a little around Lake Geneva.
Well, surely being married would not stop you from travelling after the wedding.
No, I suppose not.
I suppose we could wait. We are under no obligation to...
Is that what you desire?
I have been separated from you for so long. First academia, then your work, and now by grief. I wish to make the most of the time by ensuring you are by my side, as closely as I can have you.
Next week it is. We shall be wed, dear Elizabeth.
Excellent. Excellent.
Thank you.
I shall see to preparations. A wedding. A joyous day once more.
Yes. A wedding.
I shall be with you on your wedding night. I shall be with you on your wedding night. I shall be with you on your wedding night.
You seem sorrowful.
Oh, if a joy is not on my face, be assured that my heart is contented, dear Victor.
If you knew what I may yet have to endure, please, no despair today.
Be happy, my dear. Nothing here is to distress you.
Yes.
Look, a divine day. How happy and serene all nature appears.
Yes, yes, you're right.
It's time to cut the cake!
No. We travel tomorrow.
Exactly. Surely everything is satisfactory.
Well, yes, but I wanted to...
Hush, Victor. We have tonight to celebrate. Then tomorrow you're worrying about travel and logistics and what have you may continue.
Yes. Again, you're right.
I hear that is a symptom of marriage. A wife who is right.
I...
Everything all right?
I thought that noise was something in the house.
Your mind, dearest. It is full of things I cannot know.
I am just concerned.
What is it? What is it that worries you so?
This night and all will be safe. It is the weather.
Yes, the weather, and nothing more.
Okay. Okay, I will go and check.
You have checked.
Just my instruments, my dear. I promise. They must be placed in exact position so they are usable upon our return.
Oh, all right. Just hurry. It is our wedding night.
Yes. I'll be back shortly. Cannot imagine anything wrong on this night. We are married. We will travel tomorrow, and for this night, it will be peaceful. I will, perhaps upon our return, archive these notes. Move on as much as I'm able. This is all. I sincerely hope she will be. Your promise. I gave you life. I gave you breath and a pulse. I gave you your chance at living, and you have torn it from me in return. You have destroyed me. Was that what you wanted? I now have no one. No brother, no friend, no wife. I am alone. Like you. Was that it? I still have you.
and I will track you down. There is a murderer out there, Father. One who took William and Henry and my... I must find him. I must bring him to justice.
For what? For more tragedy. You follow him, Victor, and you will meet your end. Victor, please...
What do I have left?
Your science and... and me.
What use is the science? Is the knowledge... What good is it when they're still dead? What's the point? When will you be taken from me too? How can I rest while their deaths plague me?
Then I cannot help you.
Understand why your father is not involved in this, Mr. Frankenstein. He is a far better lawyer than
he was unable to... Sir, I have very few avenues left.
The story you have relayed to me, Mr. Frankenstein, is incredible and unbelievable. And yet you are a man of science.
Humour me. This is the being who I accuse of the murders. I want nothing more than his seizure and punishment. I call upon you to exert your whole power. It is your duty as a magistrate.
Mr. Frankenstein, I would willingly afford you every aid in your pursuit, but the creature of whom you speak appears to, in the manner which you have described, have powers that would put all my efforts to no use. Traversing a sea of ice, inhabit caves and dens where no man can live.
He is still flesh.
Flesh that you have conjured from nothing. I fear from what you have said that it will be impossible to impose sufficient punishment upon him even if he were to be caught. Take my advice. You should brace yourself for disappointment.
Then I shall find him alone. There have been rumours of a creature moving on the outskirts. Day 35 means that I should be crossing through the Black Forest in 2 days' time. I have little... no bodies, but a trail of theft and fright that I cannot help but...
Вы заблудились?
Ice, north, which way? Taunting me, I can see it. These damn clues he has left for me, drawing me north. I've been told by a ship's captain that the direction I'm headed, that there is nothing but ice and snow and more ice as far as the horizon. If he dares, I am close. I can feel it. He is only a day or two ahead of me, and I will catch him, and I will destroy him. Cold. Nothing but cold. I have rations left for 2 weeks. I must.
Stay for longer!
I cannot.
It is no more suitable to continue to travel, sir, now than it was when you fell ill.
I cannot stop.
Sir!
My endeavor is coming to a close. The creature is within reach.
Sir, you have come so far. You have almost perished.
You've changed your perspective, I see. No longer is knowledge enough for death.
Victor!
They are dead. My Elizabeth, my Henry. There is nothing left. And he took that. There is no knowledge enough. My destiny is this. I will destroy the being to whom I gave existence. Then my lot will be.
Sir, come quick. You ain't gonna believe this.
Thank you.
line is that?
Beast! Beast! Come, creator! Come north! Monster! No!
Beast, awake!
North, creator! To know, to pursue, to triumph! No!
Walking alone. Do you know that water and stone? You're trying not to panic, but the world just keeps on getting in your way. She will.